You're going to hear the founder of the National Organization for Men. You've heard on the news that he's coming to town for a big press conference. He wants to get rid of Roseanne Barr. We'll find out tomorrow night. And then at 10 o'clock, if you have any problems, you're not happy and you want to have more out of your life, Leah Kraft Christine will be here to tell you how you can have happiness in 30 days. Speaking of happiness, that's David Paul after midnight. Your teacher, your blessing, and that's coming right up. And I want to thank our producer, Tom.
Earrings to wear?
I don't.
You don't have any holes in your ears?
Just one in each ear.
Okay, you don't have 15 in each ear?
No, but I don't even wear earrings. I don't like.
What other kind of strangeness are you in, Cathy?
Nothing. I don't wear makeup. I don't like makeup. I think it's false. I don't eat meat.
God.
It was just strange at all. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Are you straight?
Yeah, I don't drink. I don't do drugs.
Okay. I mean, you have a boyfriend, right?
I'm married.
You have a husband?
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of normal. It's just like other married people.
Yeah. Just as normal as it can be. I'm the one that's 4 months pregnant, remember?
Oh, you're 4 months pregnant?
I'm the one that told you that you were the coolest jerk.
Like, the coolest jerk.
Remember?
Is your baby going to have a mohawk?
No. I don't know.
No, I mean...
I mean, I'm not going to stop him from doing anything.
No, but I bet you anything, when your kid's going to be the one with the rat tail, right?
The rat tail?
I mean, what do you call it? The little tail up the back of his head? Short hair all over, but one big long, you know, ponytail.
No, my kid's gonna do whatever he wants. I mean, except, you know, we're gonna tell him that if he does this, this is what's going to happen.
Right.
And, I mean,
what's gonna happen?
Like, if he breaks into a car and steals it in society, he will be arrested and thrown in jail. We will tell him that.
That's
right.
We're
not gonna beat him if he does it. We're going to say, okay, you're gonna get arrested and thrown in jail. These are the consequences. And if you do it, that's what happens.
Are you going to tell him this at one or what?
Huh?
At 1 year of age or what?
No.
Because I think at one, you should tell him stuff that pertains to him and not about stealing cars.
Well, no, I mean, I didn't mean at one. I was going to explain that to him.
Uh-huh. It's hard to imagine.
But I just can't
understand what a one-year-old, how that would benefit him.
It probably wouldn't. We're going to, like... try to teach him most things at home, since schools lie to him. I mean, schools do lie to kids and stuff.
They do? What do schools lie about?
Well, they say that Christopher Columbus discovered America.
He got lost. He was a bum.
Right. But the Vikings were here first, and none of that matters anyway, so I don't see why my kid needs to know it.
That's
when
right.
He needs to know, really, like, what is going wrong with America, like the KKK. He needs to know that they are dangerous and they are murderers, because he could get killed by one. For being anti-KKK.
Right, well, why would he be anti-anything? Why wouldn't he just be himself and just...
Because the Ku Klux Klan is bad. I mean, you know, just everything that they stand up for. They call themselves Christian. They...
I'm not interested in advertising, you know. So maybe that's your thing, but maybe that's your crusade to advertise these people, but it's not mine.
Well, you ask.
But if you start dawson here, you get a five-year-old just KKK kid, KKK, you have a problem. Why would you even mention it to your kid?
Why would you introduce, at five years old,
you can take this kid and start saying devil worship. We are not devil worshipers. But see, what you've done, you've introduced your kid to devil worship.
Well, no, I'm not saying that I'm going to teach him that at five. Dude.
Well, I mean, just why? See, you're going to be as big, you're going to teach this kid more negative stuff than he'd ever learned.
No, I'm just going to teach him what society is really like. A bunch of capitalists. Everybody's out for money.
Absolutely.
I mean, the Republicans are messed up. I mean, I'm going to teach them that society is really messed up.
Okay.
And the whole time
you're going to be sitting there with a mohawk.
Well, yeah, but my kid's not going to look at me funny because he's going to he will have grown up with me.
Right.
I mean, he's not going to go, oh, Mom has a mohawk, because had a mohawk when he was born. He's not going to know the difference.
But when you go to the PTA meeting, you're going to be the mommy with a mohawk.
What you look like doesn't matter, David. It does not matter what you look like. It's where you come from inside. It's your values and your beliefs. It's not what you look like, how you dress, the clothes you wear. It's where you are inside.
You kind of like looking like an Indian or something, or?
No, I don't look like, what did you say, an Indian or an idiot?
An Indian.
Well, I wouldn't mind looking like an Indian. I mean, I wouldn't mind having Indians in America instead of trapped in a reservation where if they leave, they have to give up their citizenship, and they have to claim American citizenship.
Okay.
That is wrong.
Thank you, Cathy.
Bye, David.
Bye, Cathy.
I hope you learned something.
I learned a lot, Cathy. Bye, Cathy.
Good, bye.
Ricky. Hey, Ricky.
Yes.
Hey, Ricky.
How you doing?
Pretty good. You learn anything?
Yeah, I learned a lot.
Sorry. What's going on, Ricky?
Not much. How you doing?
Pretty good. Pretty good.
Yeah, I'm calling from Alabama, Mobile.
Hey, that's great.
Mobile, Bama-lama. Yahoo.
Mobile, Bama. You're right. Well, great. I'm so happy.
Is it Dave Paul?
I'm Dave Paul.
Well, it's good to meet you. This is the first time I have heard from you. The local broadcasters in my area told me that I needed to talk to you personally.
They did?
Yes.
Why would they tell you that?
From 92 ZEW in Mobile, a man by the name of Nate.
Right.
Told me to call you.
Why did you do that?
What?
Why did he tell you to call me?
Probably because I was expressing some southern expression to him that he felt would be better expressed to you.
Oh, boy.
Mr. Paul.
Well, yes, go ahead.
The first thing I want to tell you is to get the clothespin off your nose and talk like a real man.
Got you.
and why don't you forget the term mohawk? Because you know nothing about that which you are trying to express.
Oh, of course not.
And,
well, you couldn't follow me.
You seem to trash a lady earlier, some 30 minutes ago.
Well, who cares?
You just trashed the lady.
So what? Well,
and I want to ask you why you trashed the lady. And
I don't remember what she...
I don't want to hear the opinion about why you trashed the lady.
Why'd you ask?
Hey, let me tell you something.
Well,
if the lady says no, it's rape, David Paul.
What are you talking
about? Are you a male chauvinist pig?
What are you talking about if the woman says no, it's rape?
Sounds to me like you need to say something, Mr. Paul.
Probably, but I don't even know what you're talking about. What are you talking about?
Or maybe perhaps do the thing that makes you.
What?
Perhaps.
You're not making any sense. If you made some sense, what are you saying?
Listening? Are you not listening?
You said I trashed a lady 30 minutes ago, and you said the lady...
Can you not listen?
You said the lady said...
Oh, come on. I'm the one that called. Can you not perhaps listen to me?
Well, what are you saying?
Okay, but in a different conversation, I like to express an individual Southern Alabama opinion.
Your Alabama opinion is worthless. You're a moron. You're a moron. You're not saying anything. You're babbling.
Atlanta, Georgia.
You're a moron, buddy. If you had something to say, I'd listen to you, but you're a moron.
The one we would have had it made.
You're an Alabama idiot.
With Hank Williams Jr.? No, I think that's wrong.
No, shut up just for a second. Shut up. I turned you off so you're not anywhere. You said a minute ago, 30 minutes ago, I trashed a lady. You said that if she says no, it's rape. Now explain that.
Jimmy Carter.
No, hey.
In Atlanta, Georgia.
My dimwit. God, I'm not gonna spend all night talking to a moron. What a moron. Alabama moron. Mike. Hey, Mike.
Hey, how you doing?
Pretty good. Could you understand what he was saying?
No, I had no idea.
No, could you kind of? If a girl says no, of course it's rape, right?
Exactly.
What was that said 30 minutes ago?
He can't follow what's going on.
That was never said 30 minutes ago, was it?
No, I don't think so.
No, of course it was. Strange. Remind me to ban all people from Alabama.
I agree.
All right, they're banned. No Alabama. If you're from Alabama, you're banned from my show.
All right. Dave, I'm from Iowa City, Iowa.
I'll put you through. What's going on?
Hey, not much.
Yes.
Reason I'm calling is I heard you talking earlier about the problems with Atlanta football, with Atlanta baseball, sports teams down there. I think I could solve the problem.
Solve
personally.
It. We need somebody to solve it.
Well, here in Iowa,
right?
We don't have any professional teams, so we all have to back our college teams,
right?
And I know you got some good Bulldog fans down in Georgia, and probably the Bulldog fans are maybe even better than the Falcon fans.
Well, that's true.
You think so?
No, but probably. I don't know. Who knows? I don't know. I mean, they're being tested right now too.
Well,
their loyalty.
In my own opinion, maybe Atlanta fans are a little spoiled. I mean, you take professional sports out of Atlanta and go and have to get behind a real team like a college team where there's not so much maybe corruption, although as of late there may be, it's been said here and there. But in Iowa, I mean, since there's no team, there's no professional team, it's more of a a true fan. And I'm wondering maybe in Atlanta, maybe you guys don't really have any true fans.
Well, you want to find out? Hold on. I have an authority, I believe. Hold on. You want me to find out?
Sure.
Hold on. Let me get another caller up here. Hey, Mark? Mark?
Dave.
Can you answer this guy's question?
What's he saying? I wasn't paying attention. Okay. He started to babble.
Mike, you're babbling. What was your question?
I'm wondering if you have any true athletic fans in Atlanta.
True athletic fans
of
in
anything.
Atlanta? God. Where are you from, Iowa?
I'm from Iowa, yeah.
Get out of the cornfield, man. Wake up.
Hey, I'm glad I don't live down in Atlanta where all those Mohawk people are running around, and you got these... Got these loser callers from Alabama. The only good thing to come out of the South, Jimmy Buffett, as far as I'm concerned.
Jimmy Buffett.
Jimmy.
Holy cow.
I agree with that. Margaritaville, yes.
Yeah. Oh, you people
can't
are.
Can't beat it.
Yeah.
God, you people are sick. Jimmy Buffett's the worst thing ever happened to music.
Oh, Jimmy Buffett's a quality guy.
He's an alcoholic. He's pathetic.
He is.
And this guy, he's talking about sports.
Right.
Oh, yeah, Roll Iowa State. You know, what a team.
I didn't say anything about Iowa State. I was talking about the University of Iowa Hawkeyes.
The Hawkeyes, yeah, they'll look good in a Rose Bowl this year.
I'll be there.
Yeah.
See, that's the thing. That's the thing. You could get half the state of Iowa out into California.
Half the state of Iowa to watch a team like that.
How many
people there?
How many Atlanta fans would drive down to Miami to watch the Falcons?
Right.
And that's what I'm saying.
None.
Exactly.
Wait a minute. What are you talking about?
I'm talking about...
Do you have a clue what you're talking about?
He's talking about driving to Miami to look at the Falcons. Isn't that
When's the last time Atlanta played in Miami?
Well, I was just using Miami for an example since it's close.
How many Falcons drove down there?
Well, I think he was making a point, Mark. I think he was making a point, Mark. I mean...
Dude, this guy, he's as bad as... Is this Kathy's husband? This is unreal.
Oh, the Mohawk's wife husband, yeah.
I mean, this guy... Start with he's from Iowa.
Right.
So that means he's been in the cornfield all his life.
Right.
And he drives a Dodge with a gun rack.
Is that true, Mike? Do you drive a Dodge with a gun rack?
I drive an 81 Monte Carlo.
An 81 Monte Carlo? He traded it or stole it.
Right.
I don't know. He's been dealing with Nick up there in Iowa.
Right. Yeah. All right. Hold on, man. Everybody back on hold. All right, let's go back to Mike. Hey, Mike?
Yeah.
Yeah, wrap it up, Mike. What do you want, man? I'm busy.
Well, I was just saying that I think you guys in Atlanta need to take a little more pride in your city.
Right.
Sounds like you guys are really ticked off that you don't have all these places to go. You come up to Iowa sometimes. You guys got a lot better than you think you do. So.
You're a sewer heap, but I mean, I wouldn't compare us with a sewer heap.
Well.
You know, I mean, that's I wouldn't do that. That's not fair. No, we're not. Yeah, we're a lot better than you are, but there's room for improvement. Hey, thanks for the call.
You bet.
See you later. 87. Well, let me get rid of that bum. You know, 8720750 outside of Atlanta. 1-800-WSB-TALK. No, come on, what's going on here? Why didn't that work? You did it right? Unbelievable. That's why they put me in the middle of the night right there. That's why I'm here. That says it all. All right, back to the phones we go. Let's go to Ben. Hey, Ben.
Hey, Dave, how you doing?
Pretty good, Ben.
Well, you want to change the show from 2 o'clock on to the Twilight Zone.
Yeah, really.
Oh, my God, from the Alabama Hicks to the Mohawks.
Yeah, it is bizarre, isn't it?
Oh, really? Oh, I got a good one for you.
What is it?
Well, it started with a horror show, and it ended up with a comedy.
Mm-hmm.
What it was, we went to the mall, Christmas shopping and all that mess. Well, I just decided to stay at the hamburger place here just to watch the girls go by.
Sure, I love that. That's fun.
Oh, my God. It was a joke. I'll start off with a horror show. Now, you know, you were talking about earlier about the beer bellies.
Right.
Okay, well, here comes these girls in these mini skirts with legs that look like mud flaps on a semi.
Ugh, give
yeah.
me
Yeah.
Ugh, yeah.
And at the other end, here comes some other girls who had legs like a stork.
Oh, man, that'll sober you up, won't it?
I lost my appetite. I couldn't eat no more.
Are you a flirt?
Not after seeing that.
No, I mean, are you a flirt, though, when you go to a store? And do you flirt?
Well, I try to.
I mean,
you know, how you doing, you know?
Oh, God, I'm real bad. I don't know. I mean, I even do it right there in front of everybody. I just can't help it. You just start. I don't mean by flirt. I'm just friendly. You start making a conversation.
Right.
And you
right.
just. That's fun. Isn't that fun?
It's good. It's good, you know.
Yeah, it's just. It's
breaks up the monotony.
Oh, yeah. You just get real. You know, I don't know. I'm a real bad flirt. No,
yeah.
I mean, I don't mean flirt like try to get you out of the building or something like that.
Right.
But I mean,
right.
just getting conversation going and just, you know, because I don't know. I'm just attracted to beauty. I don't know why, but.
Right. You know, just try to carry on a conversation just so you know what's going on, you know.
Yeah.
Nothing sexual or motivated like that or anything.
Sure, like there to be, but it's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the motive, but it never gets that far, right?
Right.
Yeah. And let's be honest, right?
Really. And one other thing, it couldn't help me. I mean, I had to leave after seeing this. But,
right.
But here comes, you know, what she thought might be a good-looking girl, had a good-looking figure.
Right.
Until they turned her face, and my God.
Yeah.
If you hit them in the face with a baseball, they wouldn't feel it. It would impact into the makeup. And then they would feel it.
Oh, no, it's like a clown convention, right?
Right,
yeah, I know,
right.
I know, that's terrible.
But I sat there for an hour and a half, and my wife kept coming by and says, you want to come with me, you know, down here? I said, no, I'm watching this. But it was like watching a cotton-picking horror show into a gradual Marx comedy.
Right.
But you wouldn't believe it.
I bet.
It was a joke.
See you later, Ben.
Uh-huh.
Oh, man. Bet it was. I bet it was. Let's go to James. Hey, James.
Hey, Dave. What's up, man?
Hey, you're up.
How you doing, man?
Pretty good.
Great show. Really funny, man.
Kind of strange.
Yeah, very strange, man. Hey, got a question for you, man.
Yeah.
Ready? What did the man say to the one-legged hitchhiker?
I don't know.
Hop in.
Funny.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey, you know what? I met this beautiful Atlanta girl yesterday.
Right?
Yeah?
Yeah.
You know how I knew she was Atlanta?
No.
Because her shade of lipstick exactly matched the color of her sores on her mouth.
Right, okay. Good, James.
All righty.
All right, see you later, James. All right. Back to the phones, I guess. I guess I have to. It's my job. Rick. Hey, Rick. Rick.
Yes.
You're on the radio, Rick. Do you have anything to say? You're going to bore me.
Yeah, I got some help for you, Dave.
Yes.
You need some help bad.
I do.
Your tax problems and your fat butt problems.
Right.
What we need to do here.
Yeah.
Is we need to tax the big butts.
Tax the big butts.
Here's what we do.
Oh, I think you ought to be taxed per pound, right?
Well, we get a assessor out there, a tax assessor.
Right, right.
They come by with some body calipers.
Right.
And they say, pardon me, ma'am, but you're 30% overweight.
Right.
So then from there, we'll charge you 30% on your tax.
Right.
So these people with the big butts and the beer guts, they'll say, I got to do something, got to lose some weight.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
That sounds good. You know, why should I have to pay the same taxes of 250-pound guy wears? He's two of me, right?
Exactly.
And so he should pay twice as much, right? He takes up twice as much space.
Exactly.
I like it. I like it a lot.
One more thing, Dave.
Yes.
The guy from Alabama.
Right.
Shouldn't be so hard on him. You know why?
Why?
They can't even have a nativity scene over there.
They can't?
The nativity scene.
Nativity scene.
With Jesus and the baby.
How come they can't?
Because they couldn't find three wise men and a virgin.
Right. Right. See you later. Mark. Hey, Mark.
Hey, dude.
Hey, Mark.
What's going on?
Just partying on the radio.
That last guy, I like that.
You did?
Tax big butts. That's all right.
Tax big butts.
I bet Dorothy doesn't like that idea, though.
No, probably not.
Hey, what's the show about, Dave?
I don't know. I kind of lost it about an hour ago.
I tuned in about 30 minutes ago, and I heard something that if I hear again, I'm going to turn the radio off.
What is that?
Again.
What is that?
This guy calls in, and he says, a backwoods hick.
Right.
And every time I hear somebody talk about the Civil War, it is the Yankees that bring it up.
Right.
Hey, the only time I've ever heard of the Civil War is when I was a junior in high school.
Oh.
And that's because we studied it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sick of hearing about it.
Sick of the Civil War.
What is a backwoods hick?
I don't know. I use
I mean,
that.
Who come up with that? What is it?
I don't know. I use that myself. Does that bother you? Should I quit using backwoods hick?
What does it mean, though? It
means you're a backwoods hick.
What is that?
It means you're a barefoot idiot.
Barefoot idiot.
Right.
So there's somebody living, what, on the edge of the woods.
Right. Who's barefoot?
Heck.
I don't bet you're right. On the edge of the woods. Give me a break, Mark. You're right, Mark.
I'm tired of hearing it.
You're too analytical. You're not supposed to analyze that much. You're supposed to accept that is.
Well, Dave, when you sit in front of the computer all day, you tend to see idiots. And I'm this guy, he's talking about how just backwood hicks. And that term is just so dumb.
That is dumb. What do you think the topic of the show is?
I've only been listening, like I say, 30 or 40 minutes.
And you don't know what the time... I don't know what... We lost at 2 o'clock. I just said, oh, it's open, man. Do whatever you want to do. I really don't care.
Well, you hooked me up with this Iowa guy, and I thought it was about corn or
yeah,
farming.
Yeah, about
or
corn.
I mean, what could somebody from Iowa... They only have radios in Iowa.
I better get a topic. I really should. I mean,
you want a topic?
What if a boss calls in and listens in, he decides he's going to listen, and there's no topic? I'd get in trouble. I'm supposed to have a topic. I mean,
I'll give
my
you a
job.
Topic.
Yeah, that's my job. What is it?
Should the number of kids you have be determined by income? Dave, when's the last time you're at the mall and you see like a guy and some lady and like a herd of kids with them?
Right.
And all of these kids like have on T-shirts and just faded. I mean, come on. They've got too many kids and they can't take care of them.
Do you have any kids?
No, Dave, I'm 21.
You married?
No.
Sure,
Dave, I got a life to live, man. Women only bring men down.
That's true, man. Let me be the first to I'm married 13 years, and I'm down.
A marriage is just a few letters longer than a merge. And there's no way I'm ready to give up half my assets.
That ain't ya.
Dave, come on in.
Well, unless she's got another half to put with it.
Listen to people like Tina.
Right.
God, and Cathy, this woman had a clump of hair. Where was it located on her head?
Front of her head. Now she got a mohawk.
And this woman has a kid.
Yeah, scary, isn't it?
It is unreal. I guarantee Cathy is one of these people that I see. They're pale faces.
Right.
In the mall, they have jet black hair.
Right.
They wear leather, and they clog up the escalator.
Oh, I know that type. I see them all the time, yeah.
Well, you go to Gwinnett Place, don't you?
Sure, sure.
They're all down by the arcade.
Right, right.
God, it's pitiful.
Oh, it is pitiful.
Why not?
I agree. Hey, see you later, Mark.
See you, Dave.
All right, 872-0750, outside of Atlanta, 1-800-WSB-TALK, BSB.
Hi.
Hello.
I wanted to say something about that guy that just called in.
Yeah, Mark?
Yeah, I guess that was him.
Right.
I know Cathy personally.
You do?
Yeah.
Do you have
hang out with her.
Do you have a mohawk also, or what?
No.
Uh-huh.
She, in fact, doesn't have black hair.
Are you sitting around with her right now?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Well, she has blonde hair.
She has.
And she doesn't hang out in malls. She has better things to do with her time. She runs a magazine.
You sure you're not Cathy?
Positive.
Mm-hmm. Right. What kind of hair do you have, Jackie?
Normal. Well, my hair is black.
Oh, it is?
But it's not cut or anything. And the people like us are called death rockers, not punk rockers.
You're a death rocker. Right. Jackie?
Yeah.
You wear leather?
No.
Uh-huh.
And she doesn't either. She wears a bomber, and she never wears black.
Boy, you sound pretty familiar with her.
I told you I hang out with her all the time.
What kind of sickness are we getting ready to go into here?
Huh?
What kind of sickness are you getting ready to share with us here?
Nothing. I was just, you know, standing up for her because I heard him say that.
Well, it sounds like y'all are pretty close.
We're friends.
Uh-huh. Is that what you call it?
Yeah, that's what I call it.
Right. Got a video camera?
I don't think so.
Uh-huh. Interesting, Jackie. Anything else, Jackie?
No.
Bye, Jackie.
Bye.
Let's go to Chad. Hey, Chad.
Hey, Dave.
What's going on?
Not much. That Cathy girl was weird.
Yeah, so was her friend Jackie.
I know. You need to ban them people.
Jackie and Cathy, right.
Death rockers.
Death, what does that mean?
I have no idea.
Dance to the death?
They need to.
Right.
They need to. I was talking about that guy last night who suggested Barry Manilow. Yeah,
well, I'll play it. If I get it, I'll play it.
Well, okay, what I wanted to ask you...
Just to drive you crazy.
Yeah, right. But what I wanted to ask you was about, you know, you said something about Bon Jovi.
Right.
You know, I mean, you bring him up a couple of times, but you never even said how you felt. I was just wondering, you know, how you felt about Bon Jovi.
I think he looks good. I think he's a good-looking guy.
Oh, Dave.
That's the look I want. I think Bon Jovi looks good. He said a comment. He said a rock star... He made a comment, a rock star is like a cowboy. He goes, we go into a town, we have their women, and then we leave. I like that attitude.
Sure.
Don't you?
Yeah.
That's a good attitude.
Gotta look up to him.
Yeah, you go into a town, you have their women, and then you leave. I mean, and then he looks good. He's just got a good look about him.
Yeah.
That's the look I want.
That's a new style he's got.
Yeah, well, he's just a quiet, I like him, man. He's good, and his music's good.
Yeah, true.
Right?
Right. I was just wondering, you heard Cinderella?
Cinderella.
Yeah.
I can't place anything they sing right off. I can't think of any song.
All right, they're.
I'm sure I've heard them. I think, but I can't place them.
Yeah, they've got this new tape out. Y'all check it out, Dave. It's cool. It's like folk country mixed with hard rock.
Sounds good.
You know, and
folk country, yeah.
There's this one song. It's like acoustic guitar,
right?
And strings and no drums. Yeah, you need to pick it up and play it.
Well, I like stuff like that.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, I like acoustic guitar.
Yeah.
Quality, you know, quality.
Yeah, quality stuff. You need to play it on demo sometime.
Okay, I will.
Okay, talk to you later, Dave.
See you later, man. All right, let's go to, hey, Dell, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Oh, right, I thought you forgot about me, man.
No, I just got a lot of calls.
Okay, I want to talk about that guy that called from Gainesville, Florida.
Right, right, partying town.
Yeah, he says the party town. There's a place in North Carolina called Greenville, North Carolina.
Right.
ECU University.
Right.
Playboy rate number one party town in 70s, 71, and then when they went back and rated them 80.
Who did it rate number one?
Greenville, North Carolina.
Did it really?
Number one party town in 70, 71.
Then Greenville?
Uh-huh.
Greenville?
North Carolina.
I've been through that dump, and I didn't, okay.
And then in 80, Playboy wrote a big article on it and said, sorry, we don't rate professionals.
We don't. Did it?
It did, I'm serious.
Mm-hmm.
And that guy, James?
Yeah.
From Alabama?
Right.
Hey, I think he's a gomer, man. He's a hick, I agree.
I couldn't follow anything he was saying. I was giving him a shot. I was trying to follow it, but he'd say something, and what was he talking about? I still can't figure it out. Could you?
I couldn't understand it.
No, he was babbling on. I think he was a mental reject or something.
I agree.
All right, see you later.
All right, appreciate it.
Well, let's go next to David. Hey, David, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Yes.
Hey.
Hello, Dave Paul?
Dave, yes, right.
Yeah, what's going on tonight?
Nothing. I'm just, I'm kind of mad. I went to the boss today, said, give me a raise, and they said, nope. So I decided, well, I'm going to give you 50% worth. I'm only going to give you 50%. I'm not going to give you my full 100%. So I'm coming here trying to do a lousy job tonight is what I'm trying to do. Am I doing it?
Keep talking. Sounds good to me.
Yeah, okay, thanks.
Keep talking.
No, I'm just piddling around trying to act interested, you know? Trying to pretend I'm interested in talking to you, Dave.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Oh, well, yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
so what do you want, Dave? What do you want?
What about this gomer in Alabama that somebody did not understand?
He was an idiot.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What particular thing did you not understand, Dave?
No, is this gomer again?
Dave.
Where are you calling from?
From Biloxi, Mississippi.
Oh, okay. No, he was an idiot. He was just an idiot. Nobody could comprehend him. He couldn't clarify. You'd ask him a question, he couldn't clarify. He was an idiot.
But of course,
at 2:30 in the morning, we do get our share of idiots, Dave.
Uh-huh.
Dave, what part did he say that you understood?
Well, I think it's something about Jimmy Carter and Georgia.
No, that never made it on the radio. See,
really?
You are him, you phony bum. No, Dave, come on. I said no calls from Alabama. It had to have been you. You're the only one that knew that. You're an idiot. This is not a show for idiots. This is a show for intellectuals. Only intellectuals go to your phones right now. All my local lines are filled. Toll free, it's 1-800-WSB-TALK. Women only on the toll free lines. That is all I will talk to. Women only. Dave Paul, AM 750 WSB. Next is Lynne. Hey, Lynne, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hi.
Hello. How's
it
going?
Good.
I'm doing pretty good, Lynne. How are you?
Oh, fine.
Where are you calling from?
Louisville.
Okay, I'll tolerate that. Some place I just can't put up with. So what's going on tonight, Lynne?
Oh, nothing.
Nothing?
No. I was just listening to you.
You were?
Earlier tonight,
we were
talking about men having to go to work and how that women should, you know, bow down to them.
Right, that's right. I mean, it's easier for a woman to do all the housework and work a job and keep her sanity, but for a guy to do that, it's next to impossible.
I can understand that.
You can?
Yes.
What can you understand?
The men aren't capable of doing the same thing women are.
No. We don't need to. We have a woman to do it for us. Why should I do it when I can get you to do it?
Well, I can understand that because men are of lesser quality than women are.
No, men are better managers. See, I'm the manager of the house. I delegate the responsibility, right?
You sit back and tell people what to do.
Exactly. But somebody's got to do it, right?
Right.
I take it you're not a very good wife, right?
That I'm not a very good wife?
No, you complain a lot, right?
No, I don't complain at all.
You don't?
No.
So you do it all?
Do I what?
You do it all, right?
I don't do it all.
You know your place in the home.
Do what?
What the heck was that? What would you get on?
I changed telephones. I couldn't hear you.
Well, thank goodness. You sound a lot better. So I don't understand. What's your problem? You seem to have a problem with that.
With what?
No, I said you seem to have a problem. You don't like your role? You don't like being a female or something?
Oh, no, I like it.
But I just disagree with you. I think men do all the complaining.
Well,
men work 8 hours a day, and they think they've done a real job.
They think they've done a real job. Well, they have, if they've worked 8 hours a day.
Well, women work all day and half the night.
Well, see, you like to clean. So it's not really work, is it?
Well, I work also.
You work?
Yes.
But it is, for you to actually clean the house is not really work. You enjoy that because you're a female. But a guy does not.
Well, who said guys had to clean the house? I'm saying that...
Guys don't have to clean house.
Right. I'm just saying that when men work, they complain.
You know why?
Why?
Because you're not doing your job. You're slouching. They have to live in a pigsty or something. Right? Why is your old man complaining?
Well, what I'm saying is men, when they work, they say, I work.
Right.
Women work. And I work a job.
What kind of
job? I own my own business.
You run, what kind of business is it?
It's a doll business.
Call that work?
Well, do you call what you do work?
Heck yeah, I'm working right now. I'm working my butt off.
Please spare me.
No, I mean, my brain is thinking right now. I'm thinking, well, what's the next word I should say to you? I mean, this is work. This is work. I'm working hard. You don't think this is work?
No.
You think I want to be here?
Do you sit around and read insult books all day? Is that...
No, read insult books. No, that's cute. That's cute. Are you a blonde?
No.
It surprised me. Redhead?
No.
What color's your hair?
Brunette.
Are you cute?
Well, that's a matter of opinion.
And your opinion?
My opinion? I don't really have an opinion of how I look. I look at myself every day. I look the same every day.
What's your biggest disappointment?
I don't have a disappointment.
You don't?
No.
Okay. Fascinating talking to you.
Thank you.
Bye, Lynne.
Bye.
Dorothy.
Hey, Lynne was a bore. Man, where was she coming from? She was an insult as much as that guy was from Alabama.
Sorry, Dorothy.
Yeah, I happen to be here, but I'm not from here. I guess you can tell that by talking to me. I don't...
Oh, wait a minute. You slipped through? You're from Alabama?
No, I'm not from here. I just happen to be here.
Well, you
know, that other guy, man, he sounded like some kind of product of inbreeding or something like that. You know, there's a lot of people like that in this
area.
Could
you follow what that moron was saying?
No.
I couldn't.
He's just babbling.
No, he was trying to be insulting everything, but he wasn't saying anything he could fight back on because he... It didn't make any sense.
Yeah. You told that woman what? Women clean because they like to clean?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, sure. Like, we like to work. Like, you like your job, right? You come on, you know, sometimes you say, oh, I have to be here. I have to be here. I don't
right.
want to be here, but this is my job. Hey, all you women out there, just shut up and do your job.
That's
man.
Right.
It's just a job. Do it. Man, you know, there's this commercial that comes on. This woman, you know, she's out in the forest. You know, when I get the smell of pine, you know, and she just has to run back to the house and get her pine saw and start scrubbing the floor.
That's right.
Man.
It just makes you happy to be a woman.
Oh, that commercial makes me sick. It's just a job. Just do it, you know.
That's right. Shut up and do
this
it.
This is open format.
Yeah, do whatever you want.
Okay.
I really
there,
don't care.
There was something I wanted to comment on the other night. You said, like, give your confession or something like that.
Yes, yes. I don't remember, but yes, yeah, right. Well,
or come clean or something like that, or admit something.
Oh, well, get it off your conscience.
Yeah, well, I shoot cat. I have a little kitty cat graveyard out here.
You do?
Know, they are wild animals, Dave. This is something you can relate to.
Yeah.
You know, they're wild animals, just like
yes,
these possums and,
yeah.
and raccoons that can
right.
have rabies.
So you shoot and kill cats.
I have a cat. I love cats, but these wild ones, you know, you have to worry about that. You know, they might have rabies. God knows what they have.
Right, so you kill them.
I mean, there's a barn out here on the property, and you know, it just attracts God knows how many
Dorothy,
cats.
Dorothy, how many cats have you killed, Dorothy?
5 this year.
Okay. Do you feel better?
Well,
you
no.
really don't. You don't.
No,
really...
not really. I got it off my chest. That was your off your chest night. I didn't get to comment on. And
boy, my regular callers are.
Can I tell a joke?
Strange group. All right, go ahead. I got to wrap it up. I got to go to a break. But yeah, go ahead.
Well, I did have something awful to tell you about school. You were talking about your kid coming home from school singing religious songs.
Right.
I got to tell you something that happened my daughter told me about. So there were two boys that were fighting, and the teacher didn't see it, but a girl told. Now, this is unthinkable what happened.
Right.
Afterward. Mm-hmm. The teacher found out these boys were fighting. She made them sit down next to each other, say they were sorry, and then she made them hold hands. And then they started laughing and started, you know, because they felt silly or it was embarrassing or humiliating or something.
How old were the boys?
And then she said, well, you stop laughing and we'll just go to the office and we'll see how funny it is. Now, just what do you think about that now?
How old were the boys?
they're fifth graders, probably 9 or 10.
No, I wouldn't.
Isn't that?
No, that's sick.
Isn't that sickening?
That's sick, boy.
That's what goes on in these damn schools down here in Alabama.
Hold hands. Act like you love each other. Oh, man, that's sick. That's sick, Dorothy. That's gross. Thanks for calling me, Dorothy.
Wait a minute.
Gotta go.
I want to comment on Mark.
Well, hurry up, yeah.
Man, hey, he's a mama's boy. He asked him if he's a homo or something. He's 21.
Yeah.
Asked him if he's married. And no, he ain't married. He's a mama's boy. He says he's into computers. Yeah, he probably went to Georgia Tech because of computers. But he admitted the other night, he said his mama gave him a job to dry clean. His good old mama gave him a job, right, Dave? He's a mama's boy.
He's a mama's
back up in her if he could.
I didn't know.
Hey, you pick up on that.
Now I did. Now I know. Thanks, Dorothy.
All right.
Yeah, okay. Mama's boy. We learned. All right. 872-0750 outside of Atlanta, 1-800-WSB-TALK. David Paul, AM 750 WSB.
Emergency Networks wishes everyone a happy holiday season. It's a time when the word family takes on a special meaning. At Emergency Networks, we're aware that during the holidays, budgets are tight. We also know that people are especially sensitive about the security of their homes and loved ones. With this in mind, Emergency Networks would like to make you aware of a very special offer. Through the end of the year, you can have a home security system installed for only $195. That's $100 off the regular price, and only $19.50 per month for round-the-clock monitoring. That's about what you pay for cable TV. And after all, isn't security worth as much as entertainment? Say yes to $19.50 per month. Call 1-800-YES-1950. That's 1-800-YES-1950. 1-800-YES-1950. Major credit cards accepted. Slight additional charge for two-story homes.
Will Kenny Anderson score 100 points against Loyola Marymount? Can Georgia beat Texas in a replay of the NCAAs? It's the Kuppenheimer Classic College Basketball Doubleheader, Saturday, December 22nd. Wow! The scoreboard will light up like a pinball machine when Georgia plays Texas at 7 and Georgia Tech meets Loyola Marymount for the benefit of Scottish Rite Children's Medical Center. Get tickets now at Ticketmaster outlets or charge by phone 249-6400. That's 249-6400. The Kuppenheimer Classic, a scoring explosion that just might tilt the Omni.
Delta Airlines is proud to once again be associated with the Kuppenheimer Classic, the holiday basketball doubleheader benefiting Scottish Rite Children's Medical Center. You can combine an exciting evening at the Omni December 22nd with the warm feeling that you're helping a youngster in need. That's the way we'll feel when that college basketball electricity strikes the Omni air. Delta, the official airline of the Kuppenheimer Classic. This may sound crazy, but through December 31st, your participating Comfort Maker professional is offering a free standard efficiency natural gas furnace when you buy a Comfort Maker Ultra High Efficiency Air Conditioning System. Just call your EnergyWise dealer, Auerbach Heating and Air Conditioning, for the details of this great offer. Auerbach will tell you all about the Ultra High Efficiency Comfort Maker Cooling System with its 10-year compressor warranty. The free upflow furnace is a standing pilot model with a full 20-year limited non-pro rated warranty on the heat exchanger. Call Auerbach at 934-8812 for all your heating and cooling needs. And don't forget to ask about the free Comfort Maker furnace offer. That's Auerbach Heating and Air Conditioning at 934-8812.
Call a while ago sound like the same one, the punk rocker.
Yeah, I thought they were the same one. Yeah, they're both kind of in the same league with each other, right?
It was the same one.
But. Right, just they knew each other, and or it was some strange relationship.
Yeah, hey, let me do Mark with a shaky voice a favor.
Okay.
Backwoods Hick, there. Now you can turn his radio off.
Now.
Break bad old Mark back.
That did it. Yeah.
He's gonna call you back, man.
Yeah.
Especially after that last girl. Oh,
Dorothy.
Man, she
burned it
bad.
Dorothy, yeah.
Yeah, is it just me or does it sound like he's on a vibrating bed when he's talking to you?
Yeah,
his voice is awful shaky, Dave.
I've listened to him for a long time, just like you listen to me, but it sounds real shaky. I don't make him nervous.
He's on a vibrating bed, right? He's a mama's boy, and he's on a vibrating bed.
You're aggravating it, Dave. Making it worse.
That's what I've learned tonight, right?
Oh, man. What's the deal with Alabama, man?
It's just a crummy state. I think we ought to kick it out of the union. I really do.
Hey, I can tell you something strange.
Well, it's nothing. It's just they bring down my show. They're a bunch of idiots. I only want intellectuals.
I can tell you something strange about Alabama, man.
Well, please do.
I went there one time with a girlfriend I had a long time ago. We went to church on Sunday, a real nice church, you know, white steeple, you know, picket fence and everything.
Right.
I went in there. I was dressed in a suit, and I went in there with a family from Alabama. These people were carrying snakes in the church, Dave.
Oh, my. That's Alabama.
And they were acting like everything was up and up and everything was fine, man. I hit that door.
Scary.
I tell you what, they never did see me again.
That's scary, Star. That's a scary thought. Oh, my. Yeah.
I'm for real, though. I mean, you go to this church, the outside will fool you.
Carrying snakes and everything?
They were carrying snakes around the aisles in there, around these people, and... No, this is for real, man. I'm telling you, it's some crazy stuff going on over there in Alabama. That lady said inbreeding, that's the least of it, I find.
Okay, Star. Thanks, Star.
You take it easy.
See you later, Star. All right, everybody, I'll be back. Sure will. After the 3 o'clock news, Dave Paul will be back. Stick around. Where's my music? I was going to play some music here. What happened to it? Come on, it's getting sloppy. That's why I'm in the middle of the night. That's why I'm here.
Atlanta's news, weather, and traffic station, plus talk shows that are live and local 24 hours a day. AM 750 WSB, depend on it.
WSB, Atlanta.
AM 750 WSB, time of the tone, 3 o'clock.
KP Network News, I'm David Melendi. President Bush is ready to help the Soviets with food supplies to get them through the winter. Mike Hammer reports Moscow will be given credits, allowing them to buy up to $1 billion worth of American farm goods.
The Soviets will use the credits primarily to buy grain. They'll be available under a temporary waiver.